Hey, what's up, guys? Wolf Gore here, and welcome back to Dream Daddy. I think we're on episode number 5 already, and hopefully we are going to be scoring us a date with a fine-ass Dream Daddy today. So we've got that to look forward to. And before we get into the episode, if you could hit the like button, I'd really appreciate it. If not, that's totally chill. It's your decision to make. But let's get right into it. Alright, so where we left off last time, we had just gone through the dad book, checked out all of the dream dads, and I had posed you guys with the question of who should we hit up for a date, potentially, or just, you know, getting to know them. Overwhelmingly, we got Craig and Matt. And I really like Craig and Matt both. Obviously, he's just super hot. I don't know about the whole music thing, but hey, who doesn't like music, right? I also really like Brian, personally. Robert's a little weird. He's really, really weird. His son's an asshole, and he's kind of pretentious. So we are going to hit up these three papas. There goes my studio lighting. One moment! And we're back. All right, got a real professional setup in here. The light that I'm using to highlight all this falls over at the slightest provocation. So that's just one of the joys of my broke-ass YouTube life right now. But let's go ahead and hit up Matt first, because we got the most votes for Matt. What are these? Hearts? Message. I navigate to Matt's dad book page and type out a message. Good start. Hey man, great getting to see you at the barbecue. We should definitely hang soon. You free later? Question mark. Nice and casual. A minute or two later, I hear a ding and see Matt's response. Nice. Hey, dude, I'd be so down for that. I'm actually catching a show tonight at the Soundgarden. Want to come out? Hell yeah! Did we just get a date? What's a Soundgarden? It's a concert venue, but also a band that a lot of people listened to back when it was cool to have soul patches. Oh man, I haven't been to a real concert since Amanda was born. Am I ready for this? Sorry, I did not warm up by reading anything, so I'm gonna be tripping over my words for a minute. While I'm thinking, another message pops up on the screen. PUP is playing tonight. Cool little indie pop punk rock band out of Canada. Should be a fun one. Hey, sounds fun. I didn't know you were allowed to string that many words together to describe a band. Whatever. Let's get out of our comfort zone. Hell yeah. Let's do it. I log off of Dadbook and think for a second. Wait, when was the last time I went to a concert? I mentally backtrack decades through memories of denim jean jackets and moral panic over teenagers turning to the occult. Oh god, I had a mullet back then. Oh god, I thought it was cool. Oh god, other people thought it was cool. I finally remember the strange 80s prog rock I used to listen to and mentally envision all of the airbrushed vans in the parking lot. Man, how did anyone survive the 80s? I wish I could have lived in the 80s. I was born in 90. 100% missed it. That close. Okay, so I haven't been to a concert in a long time. What do you even do at a concert now? I spend most of the day pacing around the house and thinking about my relationship with coolness. I mean, I always thought I was cool, at least relative to a bunch of other dads my age. Dad, what are you doing? I look over and see Amanda at the door, just getting home from school. Her eyes are a little puffy, almost as if she's been crying. Oh no, baby, what's wrong? Hey, what's wrong, Panda?
Oh, Panda.
I'm fine.
Oh, nothing, I'm fine. I just got sad because I realized that society collectively refuses to take pop music seriously despite the fact that some of the most interesting musical innovations are coming out of that genre. I think it's just yet another thing that we write off because we can't take young women or their interests seriously. Wow, you actually make a really good point. That is pretty messed up. I agree. And it's kind of funny, too, because in reality, it's these exact young women who are not only the pillar of this multi-billion dollar industry, but of most major industries. When will us youths rise up against our oppressors? I don't know. I don't know, babe. Whatever protests you're going to, I'll be happy to help you make a sign. Thanks, Dad. But seriously, change the subject. But seriously. You know you can talk to me about anything, right? Yeah. That's why I'm sharing how much I love Britney Spears with you. Is that what we were talking about? I think it's the subtext of most of the things I say, yeah. Okay. Just remember that it's okay to be sad. And also remember that I love you very much. And only want what's best for you. That's all. All right. Jeez, don't make me cry again. Anyway, what's up? Amanda, how do I be cool? Let me put on a pot of coffee first. This is going to be a long night. No, seriously. Matt invited me to a concert, and I don't think I've been to one since you were born.
Aww.
Yeah, you have. You took me to one when I was, what, 12? Remember? I'm suddenly overwhelmed by the memory of a sea of screaming preteens. Oh, God, I tried so hard to forget. The one where I had to camp out with you in line so that you could get a good spot, and then you cried and screamed the whole time? Dad, it was so much more than that, and I'm not even ashamed to say it. Oh, you're not ashamed? You seemed pretty ashamed when I found all those drawings you made of those dancing boys kissing in your Trapper Keeper. Amanda! Oh, that's fantastic. Oh, I gotta fix my mustache. Yeah, well, you didn't even find the good stuff. Oh. Anyway, you should be all set for the concert if you remember that. Just bring a big glittery sign and cry a lot and you'll fit right in. Well, it's at a smaller place, and I think Matt mentioned that they're a punk band? Like DIY gutter punk, thrash, straight edge, come on, Dad, give me something to work with here. Are they post-punk, proto-punk, C-punk, germy punk? What the fuck? Are these all real things? What's germy punk? I made that one up to see if I could get away with it. Okay, good. They're not positive hardcore, are they? He said that they're Canadian punk? Oh, yeah, you'll be fine. Does the idea of Canadian punk seem contradictory to you? I don't see friendship and politeness as core tenets of the punk scene. Well, punk is kind of a big genre that might not be as dangerous as you think it is. It became so much more than just counterculture rebellion. Oh, back in the good old days, it was better. What am I trying to say? Just enjoy the music. That's it? I mean, yeah. It's not like you're gonna jump into the mosh pit or anything. Well, that's comforting. We'll see. We'll see, Amanda. And if a strange dude in a Set Your Goals hoodie offers to buy you merch, don't accept it, and definitely do not go on 3 awful dates with him afterwards, where he takes you to a nice restaurant and then forgets his wallet literally 3 times in a row. Damn, sorry. Sorry, Amanda, that sucks.
Oh.
What? Never mind. Just have a blast tonight. I show up at the Coffee Spoon at 8 in what I hope is concert-appropriate attire. I see Matt out front, locking the door to the shop.
Hey.
Perfect timing. Oh, hey, Matt. Hey, you made it. Ready for tonight? Well, it's been a while. Yes, of course. I definitely don't know what I'm talking about. Ready? I was born ready. Ooh, ready, I was born ready. That sounds like me. Any situation, any outcome, I can handle it. I sleep with one eye open. I am prepared to kill. Are you? Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, I fucked up. Oh, man, I gotta admit, I haven't been to a real concert since Pet Rocks were cool. I have no idea what I'm in for.
Yeah.
Did your daughter make you take her to one of those boy band concerts where everybody holds signs and scream cries? Yes. Yeah.
Hey.
I got 2 lined up next month. I still can't get the glitter out of my hair from the last one. Stay strong.
Hey.
But dude, I get to take you to your first concert in a long time. This is going to be awesome. Just hang with me, Wolf, and you'll be good. This scene is super supportive. It'll be a blast. Quick question.
Hey.
Shoot. What is scene? Matt lets out a tiny laugh.
Hey.
Sorry. It's just weird because scene can describe a music scene as it pertains to a community of people who like the same genre, but can also describe a genre of music no one wants to admit they were into. I was totally scene. Good times. High school. Oh, high school. Matt looks off into middle distance. He says nothing, but I can tell he thinks, never again. Oh, I get you, Matt. I get you. That's confusing.
Hey.
You'll get it. The important thing tonight is that you enjoy yourself. Come on, let's head to the show. After waiting in a short line to get in, we finally find ourselves in a small venue with a stage at one end and a bar at the other. Most people here are closer to Amanda's age than mine. I suddenly feel very out of place. My waning youth is showing. I'm suddenly aware of my mortality. When were the good years of my life? Will Amanda still love me as we both grow older? Wait, is C-punk actually a genre? Matt, you made it!
Oh!
The younger kid runs up and high-fives Matt. The kid runs off and Matt turns to me, shuddering. I get nervous when people surprise high-five me. Me too.
Hey.
I'm like a small animal. Loud noises and large groups of people frighten me. I get that. Do you also enjoy curling up in a patch of sunlight to take a nap?
Oh.
That's my favorite thing to do.
Oh.
A couple other people notice that Matt's in the crowd and yell, hey, as well.
Hey.
Matt waves and hugs a couple people. He seems really in his element here.
Oh.
Matt turns his attention back to me. I am so afraid of all of these people. Oh? Let's go grab a beer. Matt and I line up at the bar in the back, where a couple of the older concert goers hang out. A couple more people notice Matt and tip their drinks at him.
Oh.
Seems like you're a popular guy out here.
Hey.
Yeah, I go to a lot of shows. This is a really cool spot.
Hey.
But it's times like these where I realize I can only be charming and funny for about 5 minutes before I run out of stuff to talk about.
Hey.
And then I become keenly aware of where my hands are.
Hmm.
And that there's no comfortable place in your mouth for your tongue to rest. I totally get you, Matt. Totally get you. God damn it, where did I put my tongue?
Yeah, sounds great.
See? Well, I've known you for more than 5 minutes, and I still think you're charming and funny.
Nice.
Just you wait.
Oh.
We grab our drinks. This scene seems really friendly. I don't know why people wouldn't want to admit that they listen to it. Let's check out the merch.
Hey, yeah.
Oh, my. That shirt's a little short, sir. Matt and I walk over to the small booth in a corner of the room, where a crusty-looking teenager guards a selection of shirts and records. He singles me out from across the room and hops up on his chair. Step on up, get your merch here. I got t-shirts, I got tank tops, I got all the gifts and accoutrements. A discerning concert goer of considerable taste might want you. I gesture to myself, my face flushing red. Yes, you look like a fella who knows their music. How's about a fine 12-inch long playing vinyl record made and distributed by PUP, Canada's premier punk rock outfit. Oh, tally-ho, good sir. Please stop yelling at me. Tally-ho, good sir. We'll see here, fine shopkeep. Your enthusiastic salesmanship has aroused my interest and suspicion in equal parts. How can I, a consumer of the finer goods in life, trust your wares to be true of spirit? A fine question from a discerning patron. Okay, Pablo, you can give it a rest. The teen hops off his chair and takes a seat. Your friend looked lost, so I figured I'd give him the old razzle-dazzle. How the hell are you, Matt?
Hey!
Day by day, my man. They do that thing where they high-five but also turn it into a hug.
Hey, yeah.
Your mom doing better? She's still single. If you want to be my dad, I could make that connect. And have to deal with you every single day? Fair enough. Who's your bud?
Hey.
That's Wolf. Thought I'd bring out a concert pal. Pablo leans close to Matt. Is Wolf cool?
Mm.
Matt eyes me. I eye him back.
Mm.
He cracks a smile.
Yeah.
Pablo brings me in for a bro hug. My dude. I'm not sure what to say, but give the courtesy two pats on the back, as it's customary in our society for people you don't know super well, but still want to be friendly to.
Hey, yeah.
Pablo's a total card. Kid plays the hell out of a bass. Nice. Yeah, man. When are we starting our witch house band?
Hey!
You know I'm out of the game. It's a shame, you know, Vincent Vale. Vincent Vale would have slayed. It'll slay once you start actually making music instead of just printing a bunch of band shirts. You got the sickest logo. While Matt and Pablo talk, I check out the merch. These shirts are really nice.
Oh.
Looks like the opener's coming on. Let's get a spot up close.
Hey.
Matt and I walk over to the stage where a crowd begins to form. The band walks on stage and pick up a variety of strange instruments. Is that a harpsichord? The lead singer addresses the crowd and has a mandolin slung behind his back.
Mm.
Hey, what's up, everybody? We're Jonathan Jones and the Speakeasy Choir. My name's Daniel. Let's start the show.
Mm.
Oh no, these guys. What? Without time to respond, the band starts playing the most cacophonous noise I've ever heard. What is this? Matt doesn't say anything, he just hands me earplugs. Thanks! I put the earplugs in, and whatever the hell is assaulting my ears gets a lot quieter. For a band this bad, they sure do seem to be having fun. I guess that's what really matters.
Hey.
Jesus, did that cellist just break his bow in half? I don't get this. The set seems to go on forever. There's no breaks in the songs, and I think one of the band members' jobs is specifically just to burn poetry on stage. I turn to Matt and try to start a conversation. So, you going to a lot of concerts out here, huh? What? So, you go to a lot of concerts out here, huh? What? You can't hear me, so I just stop and try to enjoy the music. Okay, no, this is impossible. How long have they been playing the same song? 10 minutes? 20? A year? Eventually the set ends, but only after the drummer sprains his ankle during the saxophone solo. They promised it was part of the act as he was carried off stage crying. Matt and I both pull out earplugs.
Hey.
Man, that was something. I promise Pup is much better. I just have a lot of questions that I know I'll never get answers to.
Hey.
Oh yeah, he sprains his ankle at every show. They were being real about that.
Oh.
Let's grab another beer. But does he sprain his ankle or not? I'm still confused. Matt and I work our way out of the crowd and back to the bar. More and more people file into the concert space as it gets closer to the main act. It's getting kind of crowded in here. We grab our beers, and I try to follow Matt back to the spot, but there's so many people that I'm having a hard time keeping up. As I work my way through the throngs of excited concert goers, I realize I've lost Matt entirely. Oh no! I stop and look around, seeing nothing but a sea of hip 20-somethings. I'm lost. How am I ever going to find Matt here? Where's the exit? Are there even exits? What if I'm trapped in this building forever? Am I going to see my daughter ever again? What if that terrible band gets back on stage? What if... Matt, help! Suddenly a hand reaches out to grab me. It's Matt.
Hey,
hey Matt. Almost lost you, buddy. Whew. I got really nervous for a second
there.
You and me both, dude. He takes my hand and leads me back towards the stage. I can feel myself blushing a little. We finally settle back into our spot and wait for the band to start. Busy place, huh?
Hey.
Yeah, Pup really brings out a crowd. So you go to concerts a lot?
Hey.
Oh yeah, it's one of my absolute favorite things in the world. I think it's one thing to listen to music and connect with it, but when you're in a room full of people connecting with the music just the same way that you are, that's magic. Totally agree, for the record. I suddenly have the urge to pee. Curse this tiny dad bladder. I've never heard it put that way. That's really beautiful. Also, I have to pee.
Hey!
Hurry up, man. They're about to go on. I squeeze my way out of the crowd toward the restroom. I really should have gone before I left the house, but Amanda was watching beauty videos in the bathroom. She had an eyeliner wing going halfway across her face, which was actually pretty good looking. I'm so proud of her. I make it to the restroom finally, but it's one of those single-person restrooms with a line forming outside of it. As soon as I finish my business, the band starts. Crap. The people that were initially milling around the venue all crowd up against the stage, and Pup plays their first song. However, how am I ever going to find Matt? Everyone's rushing to the main stage to watch Pup play. I'm sure Matt will be up there too. I gotta get there without being trampled by all these rowdy youths. What's going on? Oh! 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 Oh no! Oh! Okay! Matt! Matt, help! Ooh, I like this song. Give me that! Oh, you filthy punks. I'm really bad at this. Matt, my love, where are you? Okay, okay, we're doing this. We're doing this. Come on. How big is this venue? I was told it was small! Oh, give me that heart! Hey! Oh, I'm gonna mosh your ass, buddy. Okay, I think the key is to hang out in the middle. Okay, okay, okay. We're getting this. Are those drugs on the ground? Those red and white things? Are those like pills? I don't want to go over to them and find out. Mine! Mine! Hey! Yeah. Hop, 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 hop. Hump your little dad butt. Yeah! Go, go, go! Oh no, we're getting trapped. No! I missed a heart! Get that! No, no! Uh-oh! Oh no! Oh shit. How'd I do? Hey, hey, I'll take it. After searching and searching, I realize it's impossible. I'll never be able to find Matt in the sea of subculture. I guess I'll just camp out here. I watch Pup set by my lonesome, out next to a bunch of hip 20-somethings. I can tell they're judging my clothes, and I want so badly to grab them by the shoulders and explain the usefulness of utility pockets. But I try to focus on the concert. Man, I wish Matt were here. Me too. The show finally ends, and I wait for Matt outside. After a minute or two, Matt spots me. Dude! You sure are a sight for sore eyes. Sorry I lost you back there. It's all good. Wasn't it a great show? Totally. Would have been more fun with you, though.
Hey!
Well, next time, I guess we'll just have to hold hands the whole time so we don't lose each other. I laugh and I blush. You hungry? Starving.
Hey.
Follow me. Well, I think that's what we're going to call this episode for today, and we'll just have to find out what happens on the rest of the date next time. But that was a lot of fun, and I actually really liked that song. I wonder who that band was that they got to sing it, because that was good. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed. Love your faces. Please like the video. Please subscribe if you haven't yet. I would love to have you. Beardheart. I'll see you guys next time.